Hello and welcome to News Talk. I'm Natalie So. I'm privileged to have in the studio today the most celebrated Chinese language playwright and theater director in the world, Stan Lai. It's great to have you here, Stan.
My pleasure.
And for the past three decades, Stan has continually brought us the most innovative, touching, and memorable works in Chinese theater. And we're really looking forward to his newest work, which will be the highlight of the 100th anniversary Republic of China anniversary celebrations and on National Day, and it's called Dreamers. It's a rock musical. Tell us, Stan, the inspiration behind this work, Dreamers.
Well, the original, you see, a lot of inspiration, creative inspiration comes from very sort of banal things, you know. It's not like we always are inspired by great things or whatever, but when I was first asked to do the evening celebration of the centennial of the Republic of China, I mean, that's a tall order, you know, because
once a century, right?
Yeah, once in a century, and what do you do? And people are expecting us to do a, you know, like a big gala, spectacular, you know, sort of like Olympic style, you know, because we did the Deaf Olympics in 2009, the opening and closing ceremonies,
right.
And I was thinking, I think there's been too many of those in recent years, you know, from the Beijing Olympics to the Deaf Olympics to the Asian Games. And I'm saying, wow, I mean, everyone's trying to top everyone in terms of technology and daredevils and, you know, in the air, in the water, everything. I say, you know, I don't think we should do that. I think we should go back to, I mean, even though we did do a successful Deaf Olympics in 2009, I think we should go back to, excuse me, I think we should go back to doing what we do best, which is theater, mm-hmm. you know, which is a dramatic story. And so in this way also we can sort of bypass all of the, if people want to write political controversy into the centennial, they can. How can we bypass that and make an elegant and beautiful statement about these 100 years. So I thought of this story of Dreamers being a rock opera, a rock musical. Number one,
that's very special. I've never heard of a rock opera before.
Well, you know, a rock opera, and that also transcends, you know, it sort of transcends politics. You know, no one's going to, and because it is rock music. And then I thought of two groups of people, 20-year-olds from today in Taiwan, in Taipei, a group of dreamers. They want to dance their way into the national centennial celebration, okay? And then 100 years ago, also 20-year-olds who are thinking very different things. You know, their dreams are of having a normal life, you know, of just being able to lead a free and normal, simple life. And so they're revolutionaries. So I think a lot of the inspiration I got was going back into the history, reading about 1911, reading in depth, for instance, not just the Wuchang Rebellion, which happened on October 10th, which is the official date of the founding of the Republic, but in particular, the Huanghuagang in Guangzhou, that rebellion, that uprising, March 29th. Actually, it wasn't March 29th. It was March 29th on the lunar calendar, which made it April 27, I believe. Yeah. So that's the most remembered, the so-called 72 martyrs of the rebellion there. And, you know, I went back, and what most really actually blew me away was to learn that most of these of the martyrs were 20-year-olds, you know, 20, 25 at the oldest. And you would think in those days, in the early 20th century, if a 20-year-old gave their life in a revolution, you would think, oh, was this some kid from the countryside that they maybe paid, you know, just to, you know, give his body, you know, for the rebellion or whatever. But no, these were all intellectuals, highly educated. They totally knew what they they wanted. They totally knew what would happen to them. And so it becomes a very simple but moving story about why we can be like we are today. Mm. It's because of these people. You know?
I'm moved just hearing about it. I mean, I think about my great-grandfather. He was a revolutionary, and he had sold. He's from a rich family. He sold all his, his money, and he was quite influential. And he died really young. And when he's on his deathbed, he was still yelling, "Let's continue to struggle and continue to fight." I mean,
that's
so
amazing.
It is very inspiring to think about that generation.
My wife's grandfather also was a revolutionary, but he lived a long life after the revolution, and we're talking about these kids, you know, and it's just really, it's quite amazing. And I thought of bringing these two storylines together in a very simple way, and that really can transcend, you know, it transcends a lot of the, you know, you want to quarrel about, you know, what are we celebrating, you know, 100 years of what? No, there's a lot to celebrate about. It's beautiful. It's a spirit, and it's an amazing spirit of wanting just to be free, and to lead the life that we can lead today. You know, and that's what we're doing. So anyway, I got this story together. And I thought of none other than Mr. Chen Ziyun to do the music. And he was totally okay. He said, yeah, let's do this. I said, it's a big job. And it's big not only in terms of the number of songs and the volume, but it's big. It's a once in a century. It's really once in a century. So how can we make this evening, make this moment the most special moment of the century, you know? So he started writing the music, and I'm sure many of our audience also knows that he passed away early this year. He had a long bout with cancer, and when I talked him into doing this, he was feeling great. The doctors had given him not much time, but he'd already outlasted their predictions by 7 years.
Wow.
And living a very full life, and so he undertook the project, but didn't finish it. But we're very blessed to have all of his music.
He wrote the songs, right? The lyrics. Yeah, right. You wrote the lyrics.
I wrote
all the music.
Right. I wrote the lyrics. He wrote the music. We call it a rock opera, a rock musical. Some of it is very rock, but it's still the idiom we're using. Still, is pop. Is pop music. Yeah, and he was like the true maestro of the Mandarin pop. I think he wrote over 200 songs. He arranged over 2,000 songs. I mean, I think 200 songs were like the ones you can just sing just by, you know.
So it's great that he was able to participate in this very memorable event.
Very, very blessed.
Stan, you know, when I think of Dreamers, I think about you as well. I mean, you started a performance workshop in your living room in 1984, you've achieved so much. You've, you know, revived theater throughout China and Taiwan. Do you feel like you've achieved your dreams, or do you have more new dreams now?
Well, I never was much of a, I mean, you can call me a dreamer, but I wasn't much of a dreamer. I mean, I never had like specific goals, like what you said.
Think about, I'm going to revive theaters.
I mean, that would be so arrogant, you know, to like say, I'm going to, you know, create this theater culture. I would like to try, you know, I would never think that I could do it, you know. So when we started, I think I was more of a very, very sort of idealistic, you know, I had a lot of ideals, but I think that's a little different from saying dreams, or maybe you can say it is. So sure. I was a dreamer. I am a dreamer. And I think the reason why Taiwan is so creative and still so vibrant, you know, I think it's because of all the dreamers. You know, it's like it's in all walks of life. You know, in the business world, I think everywhere. You know, I think there's so many dreamers that have made us the way we are.
Do you have a dream now for your work?
Dream now is to make sure the October 10th performance goes on
I'm
smoothly.
Sure it'd be great.
Dream that there's no rain because we're working outdoors. Dream that everyone is healthy. It's a fragile business what we're into mm-hmm. always, you know, and we need to do a lot of praying. Yeah.
Did you was there any time in your career that you felt like giving up on your ideals or dreams?
Not really. I think my dreams were never that practical or feasible to start with, and it's like, let's say, like Secret Love in Peach Blossom Land. Maybe people most recognize that play as my most famous play, and it's still going after 25
and many languages
years.
Too, right?
Yeah,
you got English, Cantonese,
yeah.
Mandarin,
and if you asked me in 1986, did you write this play to be performed, you know, 25 years later? I would say, you're crazy. You know, there's no way, no playwright is going to write a play and claim that it will be still be going 25 years after. You see, that's totally an impractical dream, you know. But now that it's really happening, it's like a different kind of dream. It's like, you know, is this real?
Well, yeah. It's great to see all that you've been doing. And we really look forward to that musical.
Oh, I'm looking forward to it. It's very moving. You know, it's the way the music is coming out. We're working with a lot of young talent. We're working with people from the last few years of the this competition, this Xingguang, you know, competition. So it's like...
they're dreamers. They were dreamers.
They're totally
right?
Dreamers. Yeah. They're totally... locked in, intense, working very hard because they're singers, you know, and they learn about acting, they learn choreography, dance. I'm very happy that, you know, we're also locking into...
Is there a message you want people to take back from that musical,
well,
Dreamers?
I think it'll be pretty obvious once the show is running and when it's over. I'm pretty sure people will feel... the way that I wrote it, which is we have a lot of people to thank just to be able to live the life we have now, you know. That's all, you know, and I think that's, if people feel that way on the evening of the 100th anniversary of our country, I think that's fine, you know. I think that's enough.
That's
totally enough. Yeah.
Well, I'm talking with Chinese playwright and theater director Stan Lai about his newest work, the rock musical Dreamers, which will be performed on National Day and also October 11th at the Taizong Fulfillment Amphitheater. And stay tuned, we'll be talking with him more about his work in China.